about the string efficiency of SCRs. Here, if you observe the series and parallel operation of the SCRs are connected in series for high voltage demand and in parallel for fulfilling high current demand. Nothing but the applications are most of the applications are in electrical power systems for higher voltage and higher current ratings. If you observe for high voltage and high current demands, nothing but HVDC. HVDC is the main application for the connections of SCRs as a switches. Here, nothing but if the rating of the SCR is to be suppose 10 kilovolts, suppose 10 kilovolts is the SCR rating for suppose it is a example rating I am considering. Here, suppose we require 60 kilovolts is the rating. Therefore, 6 SCRs are connected in series. Okay. 6 SCRs are, whenever if you connected these SCRs for high voltage demand, therefore, there is a possibility of getting high voltage whenever connecting in series. And next, same as that way, and in parallel also for high current demand. Therefore, what about the application we require? Right now, why? Because the transmission lines are nowadays it should be 400 kV, 220 kV, 400 kV lines. And also, if you go for HVDC, high voltage direct current lines, there is a line capacity of 800 kilovolts also. 800 kilovolts, okay, or more than also. And for fulfilling of this type of applications, we must and should we go for the series and parallel connection of the SCRs. That is the purpose of connecting the SCRs in series or in parallel. Okay. Some industrial applications, the demand for the voltage and current ratings is so high. Some industrial applications also. Okay. Therefore, a single SCR cannot fulfill the requirement. Therefore, if you use a single SCR with 1000 kilovolts, okay, therefore there is no problem. And we are using also another SCR connected in series. Why? Because the reliability of the operation is to be improved while connecting with a single SCR as a single switch with 1000 kilovolts, then you have to replace with another SCR also. Nothing but you have to use an additional SCR in series connection connected with in series. Therefore, what should be happening means there is a possibility of getting reliability of the system. Okay. Here, for a series or parallel connected SCRs, you have to must ensure that each SCR rating is fully utilized and the system operation is to be satisfactory. Okay. Next, coming towards the string efficiency. The string efficiency can be defined as measure of degree of utilization of SCRs. Nothing but we are using SCRs. Here, if you observe the string efficiency can be defined as that is equal to actual voltage or current rating of the whole string. String is nothing but if you observe any SCR connected in series, nothing but if we are using four number of SCRs, is the four number of SCRs are connected in series or parallel? If you observe here, the series connected SCRs of a four number, we call it as a string. More than one SCR means connected in an additional one. By adding suppose SCR1, SCR2. I will show in the next slide the diagram. Whenever we adding this like this, that it calls as a string. Here, the string efficiency can be determined as that is the ratio of actual voltage or current rating of whole string to the individual voltage or current rating of one SCR into number of SCRs. That is nothing but the definition of the string efficiency. Here, another term is there, that is a derating factor. What is this derating factor? Here, if you if you observe, if the string is connected with a number of SCRs, therefore there is a possibility of reliability of the system is stable. Suppose, okay, here if you consider each SCR, we are connected four SCRs in a string. I will show that picture also. Yes, this is like this. Whenever SCRs are connected in series, here I shown one SCR, second one, this is a second one SCR. Okay, like that, four SCRs are connected, each SCR having that four voltage rating of suppose 10 kilovolts. 10 kilovolts is the rating. Okay, like that, 40 kilovolts is we added. Therefore, what is the voltage rating? Each SCR is 10 kilovolts. 4 SCRs is nothing but total voltage is to be, total voltage across the string is equal to 40 kilovolts. Okay, here before going to these methods, we observe the series connected or parallel connected SCRs of a string must have VI characteristics is to be same. Nothing but if you consider SCR 1, SCR 2, SCR up to 4 SCRs. The 4 SCRs are having that identical VI characteristics. Identical VI, that is the voltage to current relationship or the characteristics are mustard should be equal towards the 4 SCRs. Each SCR should be same. I think voltage rating 10 kilovolts, current rating 5 amperes, 100 amperes, yes. Like that, the current rating and also the voltage ratings are must and should be same. And also, the what about the internal parameters of the resistance, internal circuit resistance, okay, that is also same for the 4 SCRs. Nothing but these are must and should be identical. Here, if you consider as the SCRs of the same ratings and having the same specifications, if do not have any identical characteristics, therefore the sharing of the voltage and current ratings, sharing of voltage and current ratings of all the SCRs in a string is to be unequal. There is a problem, unequal. Okay, therefore what should happen with respect to unequal of SCRs characteristics of VI, therefore the string efficiency should be having less efficiency. String efficiency should be very low, bringing to very low value, like that. Okay, next, here in practical, if you observe all the SCRs, if you observe any diodes, any transistors, or if you for all the transistors or the diodes having the same ratings, even if you having the same ratings, but there is a problem of resistance drops. Resistance drops. For suppose normal ratings of the transistors and diodes are having the resistance drop, resistance values of different values. If you consider the same voltage or same current ratings, suppose. But if you go through this controlled switches, if you go through the controlled SCRs, what should be happening? The resistance should be varying. The resistance value. No? Why? Because in practical, if you observe, the exact value of each SCR is not same. There is a deviation, but not the maximum deviation or values, but having that a small deviation. Each SCR having the VI characteristics is to be a small deviation. In ideal condition, it should be same. But in practical, there is a unequal voltage VI characteristics. Here, therefore, by these type of problems or unequal voltage or current distributions, we are making that equalizing circuits. Nothing but we are designing that equalizing circuits. Nothing but what is this equalizing circuits means? Here, for each SCRs having that normal SCR resistance, but we are adding an external resistance also to bring the drops equal. To bring the drop equal. While we are making like this, nothing but to be making an equalizing circuit of all the SCRs, therefore what should be happening means the voltage and the current characteristics distribution, VA characteristics of all the SCR should be bringing towards equal manner. Okay, therefore the string efficiency should be nearly one, not equal to one, but nearly one. If it is equal to one, means we consider that all the SCRs having in ideal condition, nothing but there is no drops, there is no concerning of the drops. Okay, next, if you consider for a given system, if one extra unit is added to the series or the parallel string, the voltage or current shared by each device would become lower. I am telling about the derating factor. What is meant by DRF? DRF is nothing but the derating factor. String efficiency is completed. We are next. We are coming towards the derating factor. If you observe any system, if you observe any substation, there is having to switch operate all the transmission line, okay, by using a control to switches of thousands of kilovolt rating, having that kilovolt ratings, and also having that ampere ratings, also kilo amperes or hundreds of amperes if you observe any substation. Okay, if one extra unit is added, suppose normal string is there, four SCRs are behaving as a one string. Again, I am adding an extra SCR. Therefore, what should be happen by adding an extra SCR? What should be happening means there is a possibility to get the reliability of the system is to be improved. That is nothing but the derating factor. Okay, normally four SCRs are there. Four SCRs are connected in a string. If you add any another one, that is a fifth one SCR, while adding with the fifth SCR, with respect to the same string, what should be happening means the derating factor should be improved. Nothing but what improves means the reliability of the system improves. Reliability of the system, which explains that about the derating factor. Nothing but the derating factor can be defined as a measure of reliability of a string. Reliability of a string can be defined as a derating factor. The derating factor is equal to 1 minus string efficiency. The derating factor, which is equals to 1 minus string efficiency. Okay, if derating factor more than number of SCRs will more, so string is more reliable. While adding more SCRs are connected for the system means there is a derating factor improving of the derating factor, more value, and therefore reliability of the system is improved. Okay, if you go through next one, if you go through any example, if you observe this example, for a string voltage of 3300 volts, there will be six SCRs connected, six series connected SCRs, each of a 600 volts reading. Nothing but SCRs. SCRs are connected like this, first SCR, second, up to six SCRs. The six SCRs are having that, each SCR having the voltage rating of 600 volts. The total string voltage is to be 3300 volts. Nothing but the total voltage is to be 3300 volts. What we are connected, what the requirement of the voltage is to be, suppose, 6 series. 6 series means what? It should be 6 into 600. How much? 3600. What is the requirement of the voltage? String voltage, 3300 volts. 3300 volts is to be, okay, by connecting with the 5 SCRs, it should be sufficient nearly, but it's not the exact value. 5 into 6 means it should be 3000. Therefore, there is a 300 volts of make as a demand problem. But while adding with another sixth one, that is a 600 volts, therefore, it should be 3600 volts. Therefore, what about the 300 volts? We are getting that 600 volts of each SCR into 6, that is 3600 volts. Therefore, 600 into 6 means that it should become 3600 volts. There is a 600 volts an extra voltage value. Okay, therefore, there is a, what about the all the drops? If you observe all the drops which we are having is to be considered on this 300 volts. Okay, therefore, if you observe the string efficiency, the string efficiency, which is equals to actual voltage or current rating of the whole string by individual voltage or current rating of one SCR into number of SCRs in the string. How many number of SCRs? If you observe here, actual voltage or current rating of the whole string. The string voltage is to be 3300 volts only. Therefore, 3300 volts by 600 into 6. Sorry, it's not shown 6006, but it is to be equals to 600 into 6. 600 volts into 6. Okay, 600 into 6 means here it should be equals to 91.7%. The efficiency of the string is to be 91.7%. But what about the derating factor? Therefore, here if you observe, the derating factor is equal to 1 minus string efficiency, 1 minus 91.7%, that is 1 minus 0.197, which is equal to 0.083. Okay, nothing but 88.3% of the derating factor we are getting. 8.3%. Therefore, what is the problem? That is nothing but what is the problem means here, the derating factor is whenever it should be very low means the reliability of the system is to be low. Why? Because we discussed it previously on the slide, the derating factor which relates that reliability of the system. Therefore, the reliability of the system can be improved by with a more derating factor. Therefore, if one extra unit is connected in series with the system voltage, then the string efficiency which comes towards 3300 by 600 into 7. 600 into 7. Therefore, one SCR is added extra. Therefore, the efficiency, string efficiency should be this much value, 0.786. But what should be happening? The derating factor? The derating factor becomes 0.214, which is equal to 21.4. With a 6 SCRs, 8.3%, with a 7 SCRs, by adding an extra 21.4% of the derating factor can be observed. Therefore, the reliability of the system is improved. The string is improved. This is nothing but the string efficiency and also the derating factor. Next, we go for the observe for the SCRs connected with the series and a parallel operation. First, if you observe the what is happening with the connection of the SCRs of a series connection. Nothing but whenever connected series, SCRs in first one in series. In the first slide, I explained about the VA characteristics of the each SCR. Nothing but if the VA characteristics of the each SCR should be same, therefore there is no problem. But there is unequal distribution. There is unequal characteristics, VA characteristics. Why? Because we are observing all these in a practical. In ideal means, therefore there is no resistive losses. There is no losses. Therefore, what should be happen? The SCR VA characteristics of the all the SCR should be same. Should be same. But in practical, therefore, all these values are not same. Therefore, whenever you observe that the series connected SCRs are connected in series, observe the voltage of first SCR is V1 and the voltage of the second SCR is V2. You observe the characteristics here. This is nothing but the anode voltage. VA is nothing but the anode voltage, nothing but anode to cathode voltage which we are applied across each SCR. That is VAK actually. VAK. Here next on Y axis here, if you observe the current value, that is the current which is connected in series. That's why the current is to be same. The current in a series connection, the connected circuit is to be same. Therefore, SCR1, IT, SCR I is to be same. If you observe, on x-axis, V1 and V2, nothing but first SCR having the characteristics and second SCR having the characteristics. These are not the same. Nothing but if you observe the breakover, VB0 is nothing but the breakover. What I discussed about the avalanche breakdown. Or also called a breakover voltage, forward breakover voltage. The forward breakover voltage of the two SCRs should be same. Here if you observe, it is the same. But what is the difference means? Here if you observe, the characteristics of the first SCR is a triggered or turned on even if the forward nothing but after the forward breakover voltage the junction J2 becomes a forward biased condition. Therefore, there is a possibility to turn on the SCR completely. Okay, here if you observe the SCR1, the SCR1 is to be with the shown with the brown color dotted lines here, SCR1. It is also not joined, but it should be joined. Actually, it is a connected one. Actually, he is here I am not drawn. The brown shape or dotted line is to be connected up to this. That is VB not 1, VB not 2 is to be same. Okay. Here if you observe the brown color line towards the triggering is to be changing. Nothing but here we are referring that latching current also the holding current. The latching current is to be here if you observe the latching current is to be up to this point. For the two second SCR should be it should be like this. Nothing but the SCR turn on time periods are different. Okay, nothing but the SCR which defines that characterizes that of a SCR VA characteristics should be different, impractical. Okay, the V1 should be like this and V2 should be like this for up to drawn for the blue solid line of a second SCR. Okay, like this. The SCRs are connected even if in a connection of series connected. Therefore, there is a VA characteristics of unequal characterization. Next one, if you observe, when the system voltage is, why we are connected this SCRs or series means, when the system voltage is more than the voltage rating of a single thyristor, then we are going towards the connection of the SCRs in series. Here, the inherent characteristics of the SCRs, of voltage and current is not maybe equal. That is the problem. Therefore, actually this is the leakage current. Nothing but a junction J2 is up to, there is a, whenever if you apply the voltage of across anode and cathode, this voltage, whenever with respect to anode and cathode, a forward voltage, even if you applied without gate control, without giving the gate signals, there is no turn on. But if the voltage given or applied with respect to anode and cathode is more than the system voltage, means there is a possibility to turn on the SCR without a gate control. Therefore, if you observe the leakage current means the number of whole electron pairs moving with respect to the junction J1 to J2 and J2 to J3. Actually, under this condition, J2 is under reverse bias condition. With increasing voltage means number of whole electron pairs should be increased. Therefore, depletion region across the junction J2 should be decreases, and therefore there is a possibility of leakage current increasing of the leakage current. Okay, thereby the SCR can be turned on. That is, the leakage current of each SCR should be same, but with a different voltage ratings. That is the deviation. For a series connected SCR, having that voltage rating should be different. Across SCR, first SCR should be V1, across second SCR should be V2. Therefore, these having that different voltage ratings, but having that leakage current should be same. Okay. Here, if you observe, for the same leakage current in the series connect SCRs, SCR1 supports rated voltage V1, whereas SCR2 supports voltage SCR2. Here, V2 is less than V1. Therefore, what should be happen? The forward blocking voltage of V1 volts, which is always less than its forward breakover voltage. Okay, nothing but here if you observe, when the two SCRs can having a maximum voltage of nothing but total voltage, how much if you connected this is the voltage value, system string voltage or system voltage, V1 plus V2 in series connected SCRs, high voltage can be getting. Therefore, V1 plus V2. Okay, Therefore, the total voltage, when the string efficiency of the total voltage is how much? Nothing but number of total voltage. Total voltage V1 plus V2 divided by how much? 2 into V1. 2 into V1. Each rating of the SCR, 2V2 into V1. Therefore, the SCRs have identical ratings. Voltage shared by each is not the same, and the string efficiency is less, therefore less than 1. Okay, next. Yeah, this is the important one. Okay, there is a problem occurring while connecting with the series connected SCRs, and the string efficiency becomes to less than 1. Yes, it should be very less whenever going towards having a unequal characteristics of VA of each SCR. Okay, next, if you observe, how can you rectify this problem? That is nothing but the equalizing manner. Nothing but by making any external equalizing circuit. Okay, so that's why static voltage equalization of series connected SCRs can be brought. Here, if you observe, 4 SCRs are connected here. SCR 1, SCR 2, 3, and up to 4. 4 SCRs are connected here, and next. What about the current? If you observe the current should be moving towards like this of all the SCRs. But we have placed in resistance values. All the SCRs are placed with the resistance value. Okay, or all these resistances are the same of each SCR. But they are connected with a parallel connection. Their wave connection should be in a parallel manner. Here, if you observe the SCRs while we are connected in series, there is a problem of getting string efficiency low due to the cause of unequal VA characteristics of each SCR. To make into equal VA characteristics, make the VA characterization it should be equal manner. Therefore, what should happen? Here, if you observe, while making this type of connection means, what should happen means, of all the SCRs, having the voltage should be bring towards the equal manner. Okay, nothing but V1, V2, V3, V4. Yes, whenever all the voltages should be equal means, what about the string efficiency to calculate should be more value. Less than 1 should be less than 1 only, or approximately equal to 1, but it should be having more value. Okay, therefore, if you observe, while connecting towards the string voltage, Vs value, therefore a current should be moving towards this circuit, I value, with I current. The current is to be moving into the series circuit is to be I. Here, if you observe, by adding resistance values, what should happen? Current should be moving in this path also. Okay, nothing but current is to be deviated. Okay, here the current is to be considered as I1 value. Next, the SCR is to be here. Again, it should be I value. Here it is, here moving towards the current is to be flowing towards the SCR2 is to be I only. And again, it should be deviating towards as an I2. Like that, how many resistors, how many SCRs and how many resistors you are placing means, from first onwards, it should be N minus 1 or N minus 1 SCRs are we are connecting. Okay, here, first one SCR with a leakage current IB MN and next N minus 1 SCRs with a leakage current IB maximum. Okay, in the diagram shows. Therefore, here if you observe the derivation of this equalizing circuit means, here if you observe that SCR1 has a lower leakage current IB MN, it will block a voltage comparatively larger than other SCRs. Okay, low leakage current, low current means it should be happening for, it will block a voltage compared to larger than other SCRs. Okay, voltage across SCR1. and also voltage across n minus 1 SCR is equals to n minus 1 into I to R. Voltage across SCR 1, it should becomes to across SCR here, nothing but voltage across SCR 1 here, this is the voltage across. Here I am not shown here, but it should be equals to across, voltage across SCR 1. Okay, that is nothing but which is equals to V1, but the drop is to be I1R. And next onwards, it should be equals to voltage across n minus 1 SCR is equals to n minus 1 into I2R. Okay, voltage drop across each SCR2, SCR 2, 3, 4. What is the voltage drop across? That it should be I2R. Okay, I2R. So, the voltage equation of the series circuit should be shown here like this. Vs is equal to, by applying KVL here, this is the Vs. Vs is equal to I1R plus N minus 1 into I2R. I1R plus N minus 1 SCRs we are placing here. Therefore, N minus 1 into I2R. And what about the drop we are considering? That is the VBM plus N minus 1 R, N minus 1 R into here. What about the I can be replaced? Here, this is the I. The current I is to be like this. Here also, we are getting the I only. But I is to be divided into I2. Okay, I2. Here we are getting again I. Therefore, what should happen? I minus IB max. IB max. This is nothing but the IB max. This is the I. Here up to here we are getting I. Okay, IB max. Okay, that is nothing but N minus 1 into R. I into I2 can be written in the form of I minus IB max. Here. I1 is equal to I minus IBM, I2 is equal to I minus IB max. Therefore, Vs is equal to VBM plus N minus 1 into R, I1 minus, if you write this like this, VBM plus N minus 1 into R, I can be written in the form I minus IB max we have, but I can be written in the form of I1 plus IBM. Plus IBM. Therefore, by substituting I in the form of I one plus IBM, therefore we get this one. I one minus of IB max minus IBM. Therefore, IB max minus IBM means what? IB max minus IBM. That is nothing but the change in the voltage. Change in the blocking current. Delta IB. Therefore, then Vs is equal to VBM plus N minus 1 R into I1 minus delta IB, and the complete to be written in the form of this form Vs is equal to VBM plus N minus 1 into R I1 minus of N minus 1 into R delta IB. Therefore, RI1 which is equals to VBM RI1. Why? Because this is N minus 1 R and minus N1 R delta IB. Okay. Therefore, RI1 is equal to VBM. Therefore, Vs is equal to VBM plus N minus 1 into VBM. And the total resistance, that is nothing but equalizing resistance. This is nothing but resistance. The calculated value is to be equalizing resistance. Nothing but how much resistance can be added to equalize the circuit, to bring towards equalization manner. Static voltage VA characteristics should be of all the SCRs can be bring towards the equalization manner can be calculated how means by adding the resistance. This is nothing but the okay.